the 70s. My first job out of college. I have my own office. Telephone extension. My boss likes the way I write. Life is good. I'm clearly the youngster here. Everyone else is silver-haired and seems almost extinct. Buttoned up, suits and ties the women wear, prim skirts and sensible pumps and headbands. Well, at least Mamie does. Bunny and Nancy wear their straight hair back or simply down. Makeup? Forget it. Me? I'm dressed for success. Wrap dresses, heels. Each morning I apply makeup to my eyes, cheeks, and lips. And my hair, it's full and wavy and free. Like I am. My boss, Tim O'Brien, laughs. The three nuns are patrolling the hallway. Silver-haired himself, Tim's tie is draped over his chair. Tim wants to be cool. But the nuns are nice to me. They call me dear, and when I talk about my life, they say, that must be lovely. Lovely is okay. Before lunch, my desk phone rings. It's Tim. Would I come into his office? Sure, I say, surprised at the formality. Something is off the minute I enter. Tim's wearing his tie. Something's been brought to my attention, he says. Something about your aspect, your mien. I look at him blankly. My mien? It's been suggested you modify your appearance. My appearance? What's wrong with my appearance? I look myself over. I'm wearing a sleeveless dress. There's a heat wave.
In a professional environment, it's important one has an appropriate bearing.
I'm wearing a dress, Tim. Tim tightens his tie.
They think you're too hirsute.
Hairsuit?
Hirsute.
Tim spells out the word H-I-R-S-U-T-E. Okay, I say, what's that?
Look it up, Tim says. You're a writer. It's good to learn new words.
As soon as I reach my desk, I look up hirsute. Simian-like, the dictionary says. Another unknown word, I flip to the S's. Civil culture, Samar, simian, hairy like a monkey. I freeze. What does that have to do with me? I look down at my dress again, my shoes, and then I see my legs, my unshaved legs. I raise up my arms, dark hair sprouts from my armpits. I throw the dictionary down and storm into Tim's office.
Hairy? Like a monkey? How dare they call me that?
Sit down, please, Tim says.
No! Who said that? The nuns?
People are concerned with office decorum.
Oh, that word I know. This has nothing to do with decorum, I declare. I do my work. I am polite. Nancy talks to me about her cats.
I smile. I hate cats. I know, Tim says. Then why didn't you stand up for me? You're my boss. I tried, he says. Suddenly, he isn't cool anymore. He just looks tired and old.
Well, you can tell them I'm not shaving my legs or under my arms. You'll have to fire me.
I wait to be canned that day. And the next. And the next. For the next week or two, the nuns avert their gaze. And then Monday morning, Mamie of the Order of the Headband, compliments my dress. Nancy purrs that she got a new cat. Bunny resumes calling me dear. A job or two later, I shave my legs. I'm in bed with my boyfriend looking down. I look at his hairy legs next to my hairy legs and decide it's time for a change. Sometime after that, I shave under my arms. But it's my choice. How to define myself as a woman, to define myself as I am. Isn't that what we all want in life? Life. There's no other word for it. Even if you look it up.